Salut, ici on a deux boys.
Toujours le spécial d'une heure avec les Doughboys. Entrevue maintenant, on va s'entretenir. Et Jonathan et John, toujours Simon. First question, it seems that it took a while before you released The Crush because all your previous albums came out, you know, each year. What happened for those? Why did we have to wait so long?
Why?
Yeah, too bad if you're dead.
Well, I mean, we had to get a new record company, and we had problems with our last bass player, so we had to get a new bass player, too, so it took us a long time to get it together, you know, and write all the songs for a new record, so.
What happened with the Restless deal?
Restless? Damn, they just couldn't get our records in the stores, you know? I mean, we were touring and touring and touring, and our records were in the stores, and it was just, like, banging our heads against the wall.
Right.
So
you decided to jump ship and come up to that Canadian. So it's like
We signed with half American, half Canadian.
Yeah, I was going to say, a split deal. A&M is...
Yeah, so our record came out in America this week, too, which is pretty cool.
And you're happy with your worldwide deal with A&M?
Yeah, A&M's been totally great to us, you know? I mean, we let us make the record we needed to make, and they've been really supportive. Our records are in the stores for us. That's
important. You know. We'll be right back. fifth to Daniel Ray, and you worked with him in New York. He's produced Ramones and Seven.
Daniel was great. I mean, you know, other than working with him, he's like a guy that we'll hang out with all the time. You know, we went to New York a few weeks ago and hung out with him again, and he's just amazing, you know. And he just let us do what we wanted. He was from the same place. He had all these, we went down with nothing. He had all this amazing gear. You know, we showed up and he just said, here, plug in.
Yeah. There's no pressure on the first or second video because you just want to make something that's cool and that the band thinks is cool and that their fans think is cool. But now the job is to translate it to find another audience out there without alienating. They're the fans they had for a long time, you know, so that's the real difficulty. And I think we're doing that by keeping it simple, by not, you know, like doing some kind of really bogus, you know, like stupid stuff, you know. We'll just like do stuff that they feel comfortable in. And actually, like talking to the guys in the band is that their thing about videos is like, just don't embarrass me.
Roy just has a total knowledge of where we're coming from, and is not going to stick some sort of buxom blonde bimbo girl or have us riding Harleys in the desert or just, I mean, doing videos is embarrassing enough, you know, pretty much. I mean, it's basically like a karaoke bar experience or something, you know? And Roy knows that, and so he just lets us do our own thing, and that's what we wanted, you know? We're just a rock band, and that's the only thing we're trying to promote.
And when we do, like, a two-shot, you and Paul in the background, that'll be more, like, concentrated on...
Okay. You know,
John, can I see in your position?
The way the song works, and, like, on the verses, there's, like, this real compression of everything. It's really intense, kind of like... And so it got this real claustrophobia. And then, of course, when it breaks in the chorus, it's just like, it explodes, you know? So we just explode.
What would be our ultimate video concept if we had our choice? For me, probably it would just be just playing in front of a white backdrop. I mean, I just like, I mean, it's just the energy for me. When I see a video, it's either it's got that energy or it doesn't, you know? The rest of this stuff is really nice and it helps the video, but if there's no energy there, then forget it. So that's kind of what I like, the feeling. So if it was for me, I'd probably film it in our garage or something, paint it all white and film it in the garage.
Anti-gravity into space, like into a space shuttle maybe.
Walking up walls on ceilings and stuff like that.
Video concept would probably be where I am actually Colonel Sanders and I'm working behind a counter and I'm being beaten by small elf-like children with little willows, fur willows.
Okay.
And the rest of the band is hopping around on trampolines, wearing white Speedo bathing suits. And I imagine synchronized swimming would probably be in there too. And then for the last half of the video, it would just be us reading, like a reading party type of feel to it.
almost called it quits at a certain point in 91?
It was something that was, I would say, in the back of our heads that had never appeared in our heads before. I mean, we've never even questioned that. And definitely it was starting to get kind of depressing, for sure.
Yeah.
Where we were starting to go, you know, what's the point?
What are we doing, you know? I mean,
we should just start new.
Yeah. I mean,
because of the record, the Restless problem,
or DeLaurier not being into being there was really getting on everybody, and you know, we'd been on tour for 8 months, and like we never jumped the next step. You know, it was like we were going, and we were playing the same clubs, the same people, and it was just like,
It's funny, like, to just get back to the split deal, it's not so much in Quebec, because they seem to support their own artists, but in the rest of Canada, you feel that you have to make it somewhere else before Canadians go, Dope Boys, they're all right, yeah.
You know, that's the thing, is unfortunately, yeah, you know, I mean, you got to work twice as hard to get half the step, I find, just because we're Canadian. If we were American, it'd be a lot easier for us.
To be all over you.
Thank God we're not.
Also, I've noticed that it's the first time on your album that the song credits go to Doughboys, not separate members. Your songwriting approach has changed?
Yeah, we did it differently this time. I mean, before it was like who wrote the song, sang the song, got the credit for the song, but this one, I mean, me and Jonathan wrote some songs together. We wrote some songs with Wiz from Mega City 4.
Mm-hmm.
And then the whole band, we all wrote some songs, like Neighborhood Villain, Summer Song, we all wrote together.
Okay. How did you hook up with Wiz?
Well, Wiz has just been really good friends with us. We toured with the Megas in England, and then Wiz came on tour with us as our guitar tech, and me and him just became really good friends, so he came over to stay for a month at Christmas, and we weren't planning to write songs, it just kind of happened, you know?
So it wasn't over the phone or anything, like, hey!
Yeah, I sent him a tape of my 4-track, he sent me one back.
Thank you! Thank you all so much, Music Plus! I understand you. Living out well, it's true, I'm saying.